हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल स्टडी स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड फंक्शन ऑफ सेल। वी ऑल नो दैट एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स। डिफरेंट सेल्स विल मेक अप टिश्यू, टिश्यू मेक अप ऑर्गन्स एंड ऑर्गन्स मेक अप ऑर्गन सिस्टम एंड organ system will make human being. So we can say that cell is the smallest unit of life. With the help of cell, a human being become. Clear? So in this chapter we will study only about this cell, the basic unit of life. Clear? And what are the things we will study? We will study about its size, about its structure, about the number of cells, how the cell discovered. These all are the things covered under the structures. Now we will study also the different parts of the cells. Like human being have different parts of body, like hand, like legs, like eyes, like nose. Similarly, cells also have the different parts. And what are the function of cell? What cell really do? And what are the function of each part of the cell? All those things we will be covering in this lecture. Okay? So students, basically around us there are two things. Either the thing can be living or it can be non-living. There cannot be any third option. So there can be something which is living or something which cannot be living. Just like a pen, it's non-living. But a flower, a plant, a human being, an animal, they all are living beings. Clear? And these organisms, those who are living, they carry out certain basic functions. Clear? Just like our different function, different organs perform different function. Like our eyes, the function is to vision, to see. Our mouth, it has two functions. One is to speak and the other is to eat. We have nose to breathe. Similarly, we will study about the cells. Cell is the structural unit of an organ, which is the basic, which is the basic means something which start from the first level. So in order to make a human being, we need the cells. From the cells we make tissue, from tissue we make organs, and from organs we make organ system, and complete organ system structure will make a human being. So cell, you can compare it as a brick. And when we assemble those brick, one upon the another, what we will get? We will get a building. Clearly? So now the question arises, who discovered the cell? So Robert Hooke discovered the cell in 1665. How he discovered the cell? Basically, he took the cork. Cork is a part of bark of a tree. Bark of the tree means something like this is the trunk of the tree and the outer part of the tree. He took it and he tried to observe that small part under the microscope. And what he noticed? He noticed that some boxes like there, some cells like there, and there is a wall in between. So to every box he named them as cell. But these bark are non-living. In order to observe the living cell, we need a very improved microscope. So around after 150 years of Robert Hooke research, we don't even have the good knowledge about the cell. Very little knowledge. But in the today's environment, we have the good technology, we have the good microscope. So we know a lot about the cell. We have a very detailed study about the cell. So now we will see about the cell. So always remember, cell is the basic structural unit. Clear? See, every building, they have different design, different size and different shape. Similarly, every human being have different height, different color, different shape, different design. So how is it possible? It is possible because of the cell. And cell are the complex living structure, unlike the non-living beings. Cell are very complex to understand. Cells are very complex. Clear? So these complex will make the organism different. Clear? Now see, every living organism don't have the same cell. Suppose there are many different kind of living organism, human being, there are different kind of animals. Suppose lizard is there, cockroach is there, fish is there. So every animal have different kinds of cell. So there are millions of cell which the scientist needs to study. Clear? There are millions of living organisms. They are of different shape and size. Different organism have the different type of cell, and their features, their structure is also very different. Their organs also vary in shape, size and the number of cells. Suppose human being have 100 cells. I am just giving you an example. But the lizard have 10,000 cells. See, there can be a difference in different living organisms. So now we will study about the number of cells. Even if you will see that human body has trillions of cells which vary in shape and size. Different group of cells perform different variety of function. Like in our body, there is a cells for liver, there is a cell for nervous system. Clear? So every cells will perform different function, and these cells are also of different shape and size. Means if we look at our human body, we don't have a single cell, we have many different cells, and these cells have different functions, different size, different shapes. So see, even in the human being only, scientists need to study so much about the cells. Okay, now we will study two important concept, that is, an organism can be multicellular just like human being or animals, or it can be a single cell organism also. Means there will be an organism in which there will be only a single cell, but when we will say about human being, there are trillions of cells, so we are multicellular, but there are organisms which have only a single cell. They are known as single cell organism. Example is amoeba. Clear? So what we call to the single cell organism, we call them as a unicellular organism. The single cell organism are called unicellular organism. So what will happen in single cell organism and multicellular organism? In multicellular organism, we have different cells for different function. Like it will do the work of speaking, it will do the work of watching, it will do the work of movement. Clear? It will do the work of digestion. But in a single cellular organism, this will do the work of hearing, listening, digesting, reproduction. Means all the work will be done by a single cell. Clear? Now let's see the shapes of the cell. See, here you can see this is the nervous cell. It's have a different shape. Red blood cells, it is also having a different shape. This is the cell which is inside our muscles, spindle cells. Again, the different shape of cells. If we'll talk about the figure of amoeba, amoeba is not a cell, it's particularly an organism, but the figure of amoeba is not constant. It keeps on changing. It's irregular. Like suppose sometime it's look like this, sometime it look like this, and in order to move from this place to this place, he need to change its shape. Like he forced this part to come in front, and in this way he moved to this place. Clear? So this movement is known as pessipodia. Clear? Word is given here, pessipodia. Clear? So podia means feet, pessipodia means falls, pessudo means false feet. Means amoeba don't have the feet to move, but still it moves. Clear? When we will talk about WBC, it's a white blood cell, it's in human blood. Okay, it is also an example of a single cell, but amoeba is an organism which have a single cell. So there is a huge difference between these two. Clear? So what is the function of nerve cell? It transfer the message from one part of the body to another part of the body. Example, suppose you hold a cup of a hot tea in your hand, and suddenly the tea falls on your hand. What will happen? Your hand will automatically leave the cup of a tea, and you will start rubbing your hand because you feel hot sensation on your hand. Means What it did? It did that the signal of hot, it transferred from the finger to the brain, and then brain send a signal that finger, please leave this cup because this will burn your skin. So this transfer of message will not even take a second, it's less than second. So see that how fast this transmission of message is. Suppose you touch the hot iron and fingers sent a message to the brain after 1 minute, and brain took 3 minutes to again send the message to the finger. What will happen? In 4 minutes, your finger will be completely burnt out. So this message is so spontaneous that you don't even realize that there is a message in and out going on. Clear? Now see, this is a cell and it contains many things inside it. So there is something which is keeping everything inside your body. And in the cell similarly, there is something which is keeping everything inside this closed surface, and this is known as a membrane. Clear? This membrane provides shape to the cell of plant and animal. This will be providing a particular shape to the cell wall. Okay? And there is one wall also that is known as a cell wall. This cell wall is an additional covering to the cell. Clear? Is an additional covering over the cell membrane in plant cell. It gives shape and rigidity. Rigidity means toughness. Rigidity means toughness. Clear? Bacteria cell also has a cell wall. Means not only in the plant cell, but also bacteria have a cell wall. Clear? Okay, now if you will see the size of the cell, so I have already discussed with you that it's so small that we need the advanced microscope to see that cell. So means it's very small. It's very small. We can say in micrometers or in microns. And there are few cells which you can find in few centimeters, which can be visible through eyes. Okay, so there are different cells. Some might be very small, some might be very big. If you will say the smallest cell, it's 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer, and when we will talk about the largest cell, it's 170 millimeter into 130 millimeter. Clear? And this is the example of the egg of an ostrich. But remember that don't think that elephant have the very large cell and mouse will have a very small cell. No. The size of the body has nothing to do with the size of the cell. Clear? Size of the cell depend upon its function. Just like the nervous cell, it transfer the message from one part of the body to the another. So it's a long and it is look like a branch, and they are same because they perform the same function. Clear? This I have already taught you. Still I am highlighting the part that what is tissue. So please revise it. Now we will study the most important part of the chapter, that is the parts of the cell, means what is there inside this cell. Okay, so there are three basic components. Basic, still there are many, but I am talking about the basic component. The basic component is membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. If anyone asks you that what are the basic component of the cell, you will say membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Clear? And what is cell membrane? Cell membrane is the outer covering of the cell. Outer covering of the cell. So we can say that cytoplasm and nucleus lie inside this cell membrane. Cytoplasm and nucleus lie inside this cell membrane. Just think of a balloon. Think of a balloon, water balloon. So the outer covering of the balloon is membrane, and inside this you will add water, you will add color. So these water and color are cytoplasm and nucleus. They are inside the balloon. And what is balloon? It's a membrane. Now you can easily remember with this easy example. Clear? There is another name for the cell membrane. It is known as the plasma membrane. Clear? What will happen? Suppose this is a cell and this is a cell. It also have its nucleus. If there is no cell membrane, then this nucleus will meet this nucleus. So in order to protect, suppose this is a water balloon, this is also a water balloon. Okay? There is water of red color, here is also the water of yellow color. if there is no balloon, then this red and yellow will mix out, right? So in order to protect the content inside the cell, we need this outer covering known as membrane or plasma membrane. Clear? But now the thing is that this plasma membrane will not allow anything to get out of it. Anything means the part of the cell such as nucleus or cytoplasm, they can't go out, and the cell from other cell, this part cannot enter. But it's very porous, means this cell will need energy also, and the energy will be needed from food. The food we eat, the part of the food in the form of small molecules will enter to the cell, so that cell will get the energy to perform its function. And if there is any waste material, that will also transferred out of the cell. So remember, if you will see that parts of the cell cannot go out. Suppose I will give you an example. This is your whole body. Okay, here is your kidney. Here is your kidney. So every morning you go to washroom. Okay, what comes out? Kidney comes out? No, kidney stays inside, but the waste material of the body comes out. So remember, the part of the cell will remain inside it. They will not come out, or they will won't allow anyone to come inside. But if there is any waste material, that will go out, and we eat the food, that will go out. Similarly, same thing happen in the cell. Now take an example of the onion cell. The boundary of the onion cell is cell membrane, that I have already taught you, but it is covered by another thick covering known as cell wall. Means there is one more covering, that is a cell wall. Clear? The central dense round body in the center is called nucleus. Means inside the cell, this is the cell, so there is a central round body, this is known as the nucleus of the cell. So again I am revising. This part is the cell membrane, and outer there is a cell wall. This is our nucleus, and there is some jelly like substance known as cytoplasm. Clear? This cell wall is basically for the protection, and this protection is required by the plants because of the change in temperature, high wind speed, atmospheric moisture, and as well as there are many things. The thing is that they cannot move, they cannot protect themselves. Suppose if there is very high rain, okay, heavy rain, so we can move from one place to another, but plant cannot. They have to sustain that rain. So in order to sustain, they need to be very strong. Clear? Now inside this cytoplasm there are many different organs present for the cell, different parts such as mitochondria, Golgi bodies, and ribosomes, etc. When we will go to higher classes, we will study about different parts. Clear? Now one more thing, this nucleus is very important component of the living cell. It is spherical in shape and located in the center of the cell. Clear? Now one more thing, there is a cytoplasm, this jelly like substance, and in between there is a nucleus. So this cytoplasm should not enter the nucleus. So what will happen? There is also a covering of the nucleus, that is known as nuclear membrane. Clear? And this is also porous. It allows the movement to move in and out from the nucleus. Clear? With a microscope of higher magnification, we can see a smaller spherical body in the nucleus. So inside the nucleus, there is one more thing, that is nucleus. Inside the nucleus, there is one more thing, that is nucleus. Clear? In addition, nucleus contain thread-like structure called chromosomes. And inside the nucleus, this is the nucleus, this is nucleus, there is a thread-like structure known as chromosomes. And what they do? They carry the genes, they carry the inheritance from parents to the offspring. Suppose your father is white, your mother is white in color, the child will also be white in color. Father has black hair, mother has black hair, son is also having the black hair. So there is the inheritance, the genes carried from mother and father to the son. Sometimes we used to say that this son will looking like you, father, sometimes we say because the genes of father is matching with the genes of the son. Nucleus, students, is basically the control center of all the activities which are going inside the cell. Clear? And the entire content inside the cell is known as a protoplasm. What it is known as? Protoplasm. It includes the cytoplasm, it also includes the nucleus. Protoplasm is called the living substance of the cell. Inside the cell, you will see that there are some blank space. These are known as the vacuoles. These are very large in plant cell, but very small in the animal cell. Clear? Again, you will find some several colored bodies. These are known as the plastids, and they are of different color. Some contain the green pigment. We call them as a chlorophyll. Green colored pigments are called chloroplast. Again, important, green pigment is known as chlorophyll, but the green plastid is known as chloroplast. Clear? And what they do? They provide green color to the leaves, and this help in the photosynthesis as well. So student, our lecture is complete here, and you have understood each and every topic in detail. You can now revise this chapter, and if there is any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, thank you, students.